Because, first of all, I'd back him up with a very strong deputy. Because I think if you took Gray out now, with all of the turmoil in the Bureau, I mean, everything that's going on in that Bureau is being leaked out.
Yeah, well, how can we show?
By creating certainty. See, I'm afraid one of the problems over there is that there isn't anybody who knows they're in charge. Now, well, I've suggested the phone in of Bill Sullivan, who's a...
They say he's the first one in our ground.
Oh, yeah?
He was our man.
Well, he was our man. That's
fine.
Al Haig has called me yesterday and said, Jesus, you know, get Sullivan back in there. Haig is very high on Sullivan. I don't know Sullivan, but I know of so many people who do, who think highly of him. And that those are all the people
I...
I think in a way it is, and you might want to move Gray at the end of the year, but I'd get through this year without rocking that boat, and I would try to get him confirmed. Gray is, after all, Gray's loyalty to you, totally. So give him the strength and back him up with some tough people, and make sure he understands what he has to do. I mean, the most important thing over there is to be goddamn sure that that department and that bureau understand that we've got enough troubles with the Hill without creating any more for ourselves. And this is a partisan game. This is no longer law enforcement or investigation. This is partisan.
Sure. What do you mean, Watergate?
Watergate.
Oh, the Hill, yes.
And I read...
Press bills up urban knowledge, Mr. Civil Leadership.
Hysterical. But they're going to they'll have a political circus. But it is
the... Remember how they built up that poor jackass from Ralph Flanders?
Yeah.
We took the current, built him up as a great saint. Poor bastard. Well, he's an idiot.
Well, yeah.
Now, he was a sweet guy, Ralph Flanders.
Well, no, he was nothing.
I heard you make it from
McCarthy, huh? McCarthy's great comment about being the butterfly net.
Leading a majority.
I think it's a good compromise. There's a real, you know,
yeah, I can accept it. I don't think, I thought that maybe you ought to just smart and say no woman can go. I'm afraid that that gives an appearance of a total cover up, which would bother me. That, you know, I mean, if you say no, you can't have you, you can't have strong, or you can't have, you know, that then it's just the White House won't allow anybody. You might give them some others, I don't know. I mean, anyway, we can think about it. I can't give them the top if I just testify. Is that a breaking down? Because it didn't break it down at all.
Well, you know the difficulty with it, Mr. President. I've been thinking about this over the weekend, and I'm trying to talk it through with one of my prospective war partners, who's a brilliant, brilliant traveler. And his point was, which I thought was a goddamn good one, he said, you can't go at all. He said, there's nothing in the facts of the Watergate or Segretti that you had any involvement in at all. But they're going to start asking you other questions. And
sure, no, no.
And they're going to commit, well, something that I may not even be thinking about right now. But
In the campaign,
sure. Or in the pre-campaign period. And things that have not a damn thing to do with Watergate or Segretti, but
their license, apparently, is to go in everything in the campaign.
Yeah, that's right. But why should one, you know, that's an area where you don't know where to draw the line. You can't be a little bit pregnant. And,
wait a second. At least I'm going to cover that. Count, cross that bridge till we get to it now.
I think you're right in terms of trying to limit those who have had direct access to you, because that creates a problem.
I'm sure, absolutely.
I would,
but even there, he makes that hard. I don't think you can come down low. As I said, the tape at a strong level, I don't think I can go that low.
No, and I don't think you need to.
I'd say, no, you didn't go.
Sure, that doesn't make any difference. Let him do it. And let him take the whole damn committee apparatus. Of course, the other point, which I'm going to mention to Holden before I take off, is that if whoever did order Watergate, if it's going to come out in the hearings, for God's sakes, let it out.
Oh, no.
Please get rid of it now. Take our losses.
Well, who the hell do you think it is? Mitchell. He can't do it. He'll perjure himself. So he won't admit it. Now, that's the problem. Magruder.
I know Magruder does.
Well, but then he's perjured himself, hasn't he?
Probably.
All right. What do you say then? Let's take our losses. Who the hell is going to step forward and say it? Got the seventh, Liddy. Liddy, of course, is the director of it. But who do you have in mind? I mean, for that, I mean, you can't raise a child unless you have somebody in mind.
No,
my mind is, would you suggest that Mitchell go in and say, why? What would you say? Well, this must have occurred. I did not realize it at the time, but Mitchell seems to have strongholded up to this point. I think you're going to know what he said.
Well, he's, you know, John has got one of those marvelous memories that I don't know. I don't remember what was said.
I was busy at the time.
Yeah.
You
I don't know.
So now, that's the point.
I haven't seen anything yet related to this whole incident that has not come out one way or another, and it's just that slow, painful process of pulling it out piece by piece. Prospective partner who knows Sirica very, very well and has tried many cases in front of Sirica. What he thinks Sirica will do at the critical moment is call in one of them and say, okay, you don't go to jail, but you got to tell me everything you know. And up. I mean, I think he's a...
Yeah.
He's too much of a believer. On the other hand, who knows? You know, he's lost his wife, which was a great source of strength to him. He's got four kids. He's... But they're not matters that I'm really concerned about. And so we went and interviewed someone on IPT, but that's perfectly logical with that. That's what you have with all like that available for.
Yeah.
But the unfortunate part of it, it's imperative that people here not get bogged down in it.
Yes, right.
The unfortunate part of it is that it is a diversion. There's no limit to what they can do with it if they want to. And the reason you have to hardline it with certain people is that there is no limit to what they can do to it in terms of, well, hell, you know, even arranging the Democrats for Nixon ads. We had some technical violations of the statute. A few mailings that were done by different committees outside of here. Yeah, those were technical violations of the statute. Nobody would pay attention. But, you know, if you want to make them into capital cases, you can. Sure. But the problem is that they're just kind of, if they could get Berlichman, Haldeman, or me to say under oath that we were aware of anything that was a violation of the session, then they've got a circuit somewhere. And either you have to have a John Mitchell type memory. or not if you're
let purely be let strong go and chicken go.
My view has always been that in the case of Haldeman, Roman and I, the only three you can probably do this with, that they should be either written interrogatories or a planet type thing where they list out some highly specific areas. That's it, and not beyond that. And if they try to get beyond that, you hard, you stonewall it, or you